Ms. Cavanaugh, you are here for secure dispense papers.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Karuna Mistry, working at the State Center SNS in the Department of Pathology and Cancer Screening in Chittoor of the National Cancer Institute, Kolkata, under the supervision of Dr. Vilas Masoren. Today, I'm going to discuss about ATCP1 polymorphism in tamoxifen treated. In tamoxifen treated experimental progesterone receptor positive breast cancer patient. As we all know that breast cancer is the most commonly diagnosed cancer and also leading cause of cancer death in women. According to Global data, the mortality rate due to breast cancer was 13.6% in 2022. And breast cancer contributes 25.4% of new cases globally and also ranked as number one diagnosed cancer. The risk factor of breast cancer are as follows. We know that breast cancer is sex biased and it is more commonly observed in female than men. Other risk factors are like elder age, obesity, and having a family history of cancer in first degree relatives, using of hormone therapy, late age of menopause, and consumption of alcohol and tobacco is also risk factor for breast cancer patients. The most commonly observed sign symptoms for breast cancer is having palpable breast lump and mastalgia. Other signs and symptoms are like itching, burning, nipple discharge, and nipple retraction, foul smell, etc. The main treatment option for breast cancer is surgery, radiation therapy, and chemotherapy. Most of the breast cancer patients are either gone for mastectomy or breast cancer with surgery. Now, I have chosen tamoxifen. What is tamoxifen? Tamoxifen is a selective estrogen receptor modulator. It has high affinity to bind with the estrogen receptor. Therefore, it hinders the binding of estrogen with estrogen receptor. And finally, it hinders the recurrence of breast cancer. What is ABCP1 gene? ABCP1 is a transporter. It is also known as multi-drug resistance protein. It is highly polymorphic. The polymorphism of SNP is responsible for the accumulation for the influx of drug. Therefore, it is responsible for adversity in the patients. I have studied two SNPs in breast cancer. Both are RS112853 and RS104564. The study design is, we have selected 50 breast cancer patients according to the inclusion and exclusion criteria, and after that we have subdivided the patient into two categories. The initially operable cases are undergone for adjuvant chemotherapy and the inoperable cases undergone for neoadjuvant chemotherapy, followed by surgery and radiation therapy. After completion of the treatment, during the treatment we have collected 5 ml peripheral blood sample from the patient, and this is subjected for genomic analysis. After completion of the treatment, the patient was prescribed tamoxifen 5 mg orally daily, and I have taken 4 follow-ups. 0 is considered as a baseline and 3 years is considered as the endpoint of the follow-up. We have taken clinical response by RECIST criteria, and we have subdivided the patient into 3 categories: responder, partial responder, and non-responder according to RECIST criteria. And we correlate the genomic data with this clinical response to find the adversity of the drug. Now the result section, the socio-demographic distribution of breast cancer patients revealed that most of the patients are falling under 41 to 60 age group. They are mostly illiterate and coming from the rural background, and they are mostly housewife or unemployed. Surprisingly, they doesn't have any family history of cancer. The immunohistochemical expression of ER/BRNF2 are tabulated in figure 2. The age staining of breast cancer patient of infiltrating ductal carcinoma are shown in the figure 2. The gross structure of breast tumor after surgical resection are shown in figure 2. In figure 3, immunohistochemical expression of ER/BRNF2 are shown here. In figure A and C, positive nuclear expression of ER and PR is shown respectively, and figure B and D shows the negative nuclear expression of ER and PR respectively. In figure E, HER2 negative positive heart to positive cytotoxic expression of heart 2 are shown in figure E, and same thing is shown in figure A for negative for heart 2 expression. The response rate of the breast cancer patient is stabilized in figure in table 3, where most of the patient are responder and 8% patient are partial responder and 6% patient are non-responder. Most of the patient are having a grade 1 to 2 toxicity, and very few patients have found for grade 3 to 4 toxicity. Now the overall survival of the breast cancer patient is tabulated in figure 4. Now we have done PCR adaptability for ABCP1G. For 104564 2, the amplicon size is 194. This PCR product is digested with restriction enzyme HPY1883, and we have found the following cutting patterns. The patient, those who doesn't have any cuts, that means those who have only 194 base pair, are considered as wild type, and those who have only 162 and 32 base pair are considered as wild type, are considered as mutant mutant type, and those who have all the three cuts are considered as wild type mutant type. And same thing is done for 112.503 restriction site. And we found that in case of ABCP1 112.503, most of the patients are falling under wild type mutant pattern, and in case of 104564 2, most of the patients are found in wild type pattern. Now, conclusion, the patient, the breast cancer patient with ABCP1G did not have any significant association with the response rate. The median overall survival achieved within 48 months, and furthermore, no statistical significance was found with the adverse event of tamoxifen. Hence, ABCP1 polymorphism may not be a predictive treatment outcome of patient with respect to hormone receptor positive patients. However, further investigation is required with larger sample size. Finally, I would like to acknowledge CSIR for funding for the financial support. Thank you.
Thank you.